Scorpio, I'm going to do a, for you, I'm going to do a six card spread. A simple six card across. And let's take clarification. But it's going to be, so two present cards, so two past cards, two present cards, two future cards. Wow, two cups, ace of cups, page of cups. Don't pay any attention to the fact that it was upside down and reversed. I don't do reversals, except for when I do, and that is not very often. Ten of Pentacles, page of cups. Okay, so let's cut the deck. Wow, well, three cards wanted to come off the top there. Oh no, there's only two. Okay, interesting. Six of Cups and Temperance. So that's your two past cards. Or maybe that, no, I'm getting that as present. That's current. Okay. I'm going to cut the deck again, I'm being told. Two past cards of Wicked. Death. And three keys. Okay? Wow, and I'm going to cut the deck again. Right there, and take those two for the future. The Wheel of Fortune and the High Priestess. Now, Cancer had the High Priestess in his outcome, in her outcome energy, his outcome energy on a Celtic cross. So, maybe you want to go and look at that. Wow. So, past energy, death, rebirth. Three keys. So, that death, that transformation, that part of you that had to die, that part of you that had to go away, couldn't be anymore, has opened the doorway on this three keys, possibly one of the best oracle cards in the deck, in this deck, in my deck. And then there's this central energy, six of cups and temperance. Now, I'm not even going to say it because I'm not getting it at all, but I'm just not, this six is a great number, and cups, love, fantastic. So to get that with temperance, which is a healing energy, temperance, fire triangle on her chest here, goddess descending. Now the way you're just not going to be able to see it on there, but I did represent the two cup water into wine thing on the center here of the body of this temperance person, this androgynous person, goddess. And then the High Priestess, she sees all, she knows all. Very spiritually intuitive, very in touch with the divine. I'm getting the word telepathic on that. Okay? And then the Wheel of Fortune. As an outro. Okay, so I'm gonna pull clarification. Oh, okay. Yeah, clarification with this deck. That definitely wanted to come out. Ace of Wands. Death, Ace of Wands. So that's how big the beginning. The beginning after that, rebirth, was pretty special. And three keys, judgment. So literally, a judgment is going in your favour. To have it with the three keys like that, to have that judgment card with that three keys oracle card is massive. Huge, in fact. That's huge. So a judgment went in your favour in the past. Or is going to. It was the message I'm getting that it was the steps towards it going in your favour started possibly quite a while ago. But it might not be resolved yet, is what I'm hearing. Okay, I'm going to shuffle. Ooh. Wow! Ace of Pentacles and the Fool on the card. Deary me! I've lost all power to shuffle. Okay, Six of Cups and Temperance. There's one. Two of Swords. So the lady on the Two of Swords could be a guy. It's blindfolded. So sometimes it can mean choosing a direction. And there's land behind her there. That's what she needs to be choosing. The getting over that sea, ocean, water. And there is a moon here, sort of very small in the sky. But you can clearly see it, even you can see it right there. So that could be talking about a water sign, possibly. Wow, the deck just fell open at the Ten of Pentacles there. Okay, Scorpio, I hope you're paying attention. The Magician. Okay. I think you know who this is, Scorpio. Wow. And the Queen of Swords and the King of Pentacles. So, central energy, present, current energy. Six of Cups, Temperance, Two of Swords, Magician, Queen of Swords, King of Pentacles. Similar to the... There was some of that energy in the Pisces reading. Maybe that might mean something to you. Maybe it doesn't. Take what resonates and leave the rest. Okay, so this is for the High Priestess and the Wheel of Fortune. I've got the Nine of Swords here. That blindfolded, trapped energy. So what I'm getting is, you, viewer, querent, might be feeling like this, you're scared of this situation because you feel like it's going to trap you, and it's not going to trap you. That's what I'm here to tell you, whoever this message is for. No. Wow. Well, that was a bit messy, really. But I'm going to take them. Wow. So we've got the High Priestess, Nine of Swords, and the High Priestess. With the King of Swords. The Queen was over there, remember? So divine counterparts showing up there. In that way. The Moon. So I'm thinking that watery energy that I was talking about is a Pisces. Scorpio. That's you. Nine of Wands. Didn't we get the Nine of Wands? Nine of Wands and the Eight of Pentacles. So something you've been working really, really hard at is going to bring in this Wheel of Fortune. And the two that went on the floor, I am getting a bit of sneaky energy on this. So in the future, just look out for any sneaky energy. But it's not going to be coming from whoever you are imagining is this water sign, is this magician, is this Queen of Swords, this King of Pentacles, this, even though those are air and earth. This is going to resonate with you if you know what I'm talking about. They're not going to be sneaky. They have no intention of, I'm getting it, so I'm going to say it. They have no intention of taking any of your money, spending any of your money. They have got plenty of their own. Okay? But just beware of that, though, in the future. Guidance. This is guidance. I'd say generally, as a general, just always be a little bit wary of sneaky people, really. I mean, that's a good message for all times, for anything, for all seasons, for all reasons. Okay? Okay, Scorpio. Okay, I am being told to take that card that's popping out there, and it's the Chariot. Now, I never normally do I say this, but I'm being told by spirit to say this. The numerology on my name is the Chariot. The Chariot in the deck is my card. That's the card that is me, numerologically. And I've never said it before, but maybe I shouldn't have said that. But that is. That's me. Okay. Oh, and we've got the Queen of Cups on the bottom. The Queen of the World. The Nurturing Queen. Nurturing motherly energy. Oh, and the Emperor afterwards. Okay? Okay, big time. Peace be the journey of life, Scorpio. Take care. Bye.
All clear.
T-Bird 8, we need you to pull in close. 40 Mike in here right now.